we will go to the lesson. All of you, look at the lesson, the supplement lesson, and we will go to the lesson line by line. Okay, the wonder called sleep. Our body and brain recover from fatigue after a good sleep. We dream while we sleep. See, when we sleep, we'll have dreams, but we do not always remember our dreams. We cannot memorize the dreams which we had in the previous night. During sleep, our heartbeat becomes slower. That I have already written, slower. Temperature and blood pressure goes low. So, we know enough about what is sleep. Though we do not know what exactly causes sleep. Sleep is a state of rest. Sleep is a state of rest. And unconscious rest. When we sleep, our body recovers from fatigue caused by the day's activities. After a good sleep and the rest that it gives, we become alert and active again, ready for the normal activities of the day. After a good sleep, we will become very active for the rest of the day. When we wake up in the morning, it is not always possible for us to remember what happened when we were asleep. We will not be able to remember what all things happened during our sleep. We may remember a dream, but the rest of our sleep was a kind of darkness in which nothing seems to have taken place. So, during sleep, we will get, we will have dreams. But sometimes, when already suddenly in the morning, we will not remember whether we had a dream. But sometimes when we go through the day, sometimes the dream comes in our mind. But the end of the dream, very, very literally, we will memorize the rest, the whole thing. Most of us cannot remember the whole dreams. Only some bit we will remember, which will be related to our day-to-day life. The dreams will be related to our day-to-day life, but we cannot remember what is the future. Several things happen to our body while we are sleeping. So, the temperature goes down, the blood pressure goes down, and the brain goes slow. All these things happen. Several things happen to our body while we are sleeping. As we sink deeper into sleep, our muscles relax more and more. Our heartbeat becomes slower. Our temperature and blood pressure go down. The ever-active brain also slows down, so that we can't think of or act consciously, but we dream. When we wake up, our temperature and blood pressure rise to normal. During sleep, our temperature and blood pressure goes down. But when we rise, the temperature and the blood pressure comes to normal. Our heartbeat and breathing also become normal, and we are fully awake. And while sleep, our heartbeat slows down. But when we wake up, the heartbeat comes to normal. And have forgotten most, if not all, the dreams that we had while sleeping. What is a dream? It is an activity of the mind that takes place when we are asleep. Some dreams are probable while others are not. Some dreams we will remember. But early morning as we get up, we will not remember whether we had any dream. But after, when the day goes on moving, then sometimes it will strike in our mind. Some dreams are probable while others are not. That only means that many of the things that happen in dreams could happen when we are awake. Others could not. Dreams seem to be important for several reasons. Dreams seem to be important for several reasons. One is that a dream can help us to sleep through noise or other disturbances. That is, one is that the sleep can help us to, the dreams can help us to sleep through noises and other disturbances. For example, the alarm clock rings, but our mind causes us to dream that the telephone or doorbell is ringing. Sometimes the alarm rings, we will in the sleep, in the dream, we will think that it is the doorbell, or it is the ringing sound of our phone. But actually, that is the alarm to wake up. But we are in a dream, our mind is like that, so we will feel like that. Doorbell is ringing, and that we are awake and answering it. Certain doctors have found that one's dreams often reveal a great deal about one's problems, and that if understood correctly, they can provide a key to the solution of those problems. But we must remember one thing: dreams cannot be used as a way to tell the future. They simply can never tell the future. Okay. Sleep is the most common experience, but how many of us really think about the wonder and power of sleep? Many poets have written beautiful poems about sleep. Here is one in which the poet is describing the experience of falling asleep. Now, a poem about sleep. Lights out. The name of the poem is Lights Out. I have come to the borders of sleep, the unfathomable deep. Unfathomable means we cannot measure it. The deep. Forests were almost loose. Their way, however straight or winding, soon or late, they cannot choose. There is not any book or face of dearest look that I would not turn from now. Into the unknown. I must enter and leave alone. I know it not how. Okay, that is the poem. Okay, and this beautiful lesson is written by Edward Thomas. And after this, you have to read this lesson carefully. And I twice or thrice you have to read the lesson carefully. Then after that, I'll give the notes also. Okay, thank you.